at the World Championships. So we had high hopes for them coming into this, but I think even though, I mean, they impressed themselves there. That was just perfect.
Oh, no, no. They should be really, really pleased for themselves. And getting a Scottish gold, that's incredible.
What a game Scotland have had. I mean, just fantastic, isn't it?
Absolutely. Like, fair play to them. They're absolutely brilliant. Really pleased.
Let's have a look at some of their dives, actually, here, and you can talk us through just what made them so special. I think we can see their fourth dive here, and I think this is at this point we started to feel very confident for them.
That's it. They have a great hurdle. The takeoff was a little bit out, but in the air they got together. The twist at the same time. They look for the entry together, and they both completely disappear. And that's exactly what the judges are looking for, that last little part. They know they can do that dive every time, to be honest.
Did you feel they got better as the competition progressed on you?
Absolutely. They were probably nervous. Yeah. You know, every single one looked pretty nervous at the start. But as soon as you hit a good optional, which is the third round, you can relax a little bit. Yeah. And I think that's exactly what they've done today.
It's funny, they're one of the few pairings that have worked together before. And, you know, you could see that, you know, that experience comes through, doesn't it?
Oh, definitely. They've had a lot of practice and it did show today because we had a few newbies, which was really nice to see. And, of course, Matthew Dixon couldn't dive, so Jordan stepped in at the last minute. Mm-hmm. And considering they did a great job, really,
let's
really good
Let's take a look
job.
At the fifth dive. Just talk us through this, Tonya.
Another hurdle step, which is scary when you're doing a mixed synchro. But they seem to get it spot on, and they, yet again, nailed another dive. And they're consistent, and that's exactly what you're looking for.
It's something we talked about earlier. You know, this is so difficult, and I think that's why that, you know, that having worked together before really does make the difference here. It's not easy just to pick up and
absolutely not
and start together.
James actually does a front 4.5 somersaults when he competes individually, so the fact that he came back to do a 3.5 somersault, you know, that cannot be easy for a diver, but he made it look pretty simple today. It was really, really good.
Shall we hear from them then?
Let's do that.
I think they're speaking to Catherine Downes right now. Let's hear from them.
Well done.
Thank you.
Tonya, just how good is that pizza?
Oh, it's amazing.
After a few days of competing.
Pizza's always good.
I remember it. I actually remember after Olympic Games, we had McDonald's in the venue, and I had it 7 days in a row when I was finished. So, yeah, it was amazing. So I understand how they feel right now.
Yeah.
And I hope they go and enjoy it. They deserve it.
Yeah, and what a moment for them. I mean, they said it themselves, over the moon. And just to come so close to gold so many times and miss out, it just makes it that a little bit sweeter.
I know. Like, it was fantastic to watch. I feel how excited they are and how much work puts into it, you know? Well deserved, and I can't wait to see them later. Give them a big hug.
Do you know, it's
another gold medal for Scotland. Fantastic, you know, they've been brilliant throughout this whole tournament, and especially games. That's the football coming out. That's what happened there. It's amazing for Scotland. You know, we've seen how impressive they've been on the track as well, but a gold medal in diving, I mean, sensational stuff.
I know. I don't think it's quite sunk in yet. They're buzzing, but wait till they get back, relax, and look at their medal, and it's really going to be fantastic for them.
That moment when you realise
great
that
goal.
You've
wrong sport.
Stay with us. You get back there very soon. Stay with me. But I think it's lovely on the final day, isn't it? We get to this point where we sort of reflect on what our kind of highlights of the games will be. I mean, obviously for Scotland, that's got to be up there for them. So many incredible moments. For me, though, I was thinking about this last night. Laura Kenny last week, she has had just obviously the most phenomenal career, and then we're seeing her here win another gold medal. It was just so special, and she calls herself the granny of British track cycling. And she woke up the morning of this race, she woke up and she said, I'm going to retire, this is going to be my last ever moment on the track. And then she went off to the bathroom, gave herself a bit of a talking to, and said she wanted to remember who she was, that Laura Trott, you know, not dame, not mother, everything that she's been through over the past couple of years. And she came out here and she won gold in the 10K scratch race. And this was just such a phenomenal moment. And she gave this brilliant interview afterwards. And I think it spurred all of us on for the rest of these games. even though, like, so she mentions Adam Peaty here. It was so emotional. But yeah, you have to hear it to believe it. And even this interview is one of my highlights.
I'm having a serious confidence crisis. I just didn't want to be on the track. And whenever I feel like that, I race badly. And that's what happened yesterday. I race badly. and then I don't get a result. Whereas today, I was so fired up. I kept saying to myself in the toilet, I was like, I can do this. And then some man on the start line, because obviously I haven't got any points, so I'm way down the back of the track at the start, and he goes, you've got this, Laura. And honestly, I wanted to turn around to him and be like, yes, I have. I just look like a completely different bike rider.
Do you know what? I really want to find that guy. I don't think we ever did. We never find the guy who was at the start of the starting line saying, you've got this, Laura.
It almost feels as if we need to get that on a T-shirt. You've got
you've
this, Laura.
Got this,
so you know when you're in the gym and you're struggling to get over the 5K mark or 1K, in my experience, you've got this, Laura, emblazoned on a T-shirt. That's what we need. Because how powerful is that?
We need that. We need to find that man. Yeah. We need to get his number. And if anyone's feeling down, let's just give him a call.
Yeah.
Hey, you OK? You've got this. Thank you.
Yeah. Just stand next to me in the treadmill. Yeah.
If you're having a tough day, play that interview.
Yeah,
because that is so
that.
Inspirational, isn't it?
It was. And it was funny. She mentioned Adam Peaty in it as well, about him talking about, you know, losing his spark. And I think it's something that a lot of the athletes who have been winning gold medals at the Olympics and the... You know, they're the face of these games and there's so much pressure on them. And then sometimes they kind of forget why they even started.
Absolutely.
They forget about that little girl, that little boy who wanted to get in the pool or wanted to get, you know, on the track. And it wasn't about gold medals, it was about enjoying it. And I feel like that Laura Kenny, Laura Trott, you know, we just saw that side of her again. It was just great to see.
Yeah.
Loved it.
Great choice. What's your second choice?
It was actually just last night.
Okay.
I got myself really involved back at the Alexander Stadium. And Laura Muir, I mean, she is something else. In the 1500 metres, we saw her win a medal in the 800 metres, but this is her event. That moment when she kicks in, that acceleration, I mean, there's just nothing quite like it. And everyone knew she was going to win gold in this race. But just behind her here, Northern Ireland's Ciara McGeehan. This is a phenomenal moment for her. She won silver last night. This is the third time of asking. She's never won a medal at the Commonwealth Games. And right from the very beginning, you could see she was just watching Laura Muir the whole time, going, I'm not letting you out of my sight. I might not be able to beat you, but I'm going to get as close as I possibly can. But for that moment there, for Laura Muir to stand up, Flower of Scotland playing once again, she's just phenomenal. And she missed out on the Commonwealth Games too so many times because she had to study for her veterinary exams, you know, and different things. So, yeah, just to get that gold medal last night, you could see it meant so much to her.
Amazing, because as athletes, you know, you do have those difficult moments, don't you, Tonya? You've probably been there yourself.
Of course, yeah. There's injuries that get in the way. There's so much mental things that get in the way. Like, it's not a smooth ride for anybody, even the top of the game of the people that, there's, you know, it's like this. Up and down, and you just have to find a way to deal with it.
You know, it's the side of that of sport that we don't talk about. We focus so much, you know, on what we see on camera, what you know, with those winning moments. But it's behind the scenes, the stuff that goes on between these major events. I mean, that matters so much more.
Absolutely. You know, for the divers, you step onto the board, you wouldn't believe what's gone on behind the scenes because you just got a straight face and you just watch them and their moment and you forget everything else. But yeah, there's so much behind the scenes.
And don't forget, you're involved in an individual sport as well. Okay, if you've got a partner in the diving, then obviously you can look to each other for inspiration. But when you're an individual sport, you haven't got the team members to rally you around if perhaps you're having a difficult day.
I know. And, you know, that's when you've got amazing family and friends for support. You know, you could go home and they can help you as much as they can without being pushy, without being too much on you with pressure and stuff. Like, I was very, very lucky to have such amazing support system around me that helped me guide me through my career.
Yeah, it can be lonely, you know, and it's interesting. We've seen it in so many different sports, the relationships that blossom, so many couples, you know, the Adcocks in today, and, you know, Jack Law, of course, and Lewis, you know, and it's interesting that happens because it's nice to have that support right there, particularly in those individual
events. For sure, and I can understand why that happens, like, for sure, but, like, some people prefer to have a partner outside for something different, you know, something else to talk about and maybe forget their sport. So it works both ways. And I can totally understand why these guys get together because they live, eat and breathe sport. So it makes total sense, doesn't it?
I love getting all these little insights. You have a think, Tonya, what your highlight of the game is. I'd be interested to hear that.
Yes,
but what about you, Jason?
Definitely. Well, I've chosen because if you're having a difficult day, there's nothing better than having a dance and having a sing song.
Oh, yes, we love a boogie here.
So we were at the beach volleyball when this happened. And we have to say congratulations to Chris Clark and James Lambert for being the stars of the show. So just have a listen to this. This is Queen, I Want to Break Free, featuring Chris Clark and James Lambert. I'm you go. Chris Clark and James Lambert doing their very best Freddie impressions there.
I love it.
The beach volleyball. It was so good.
That's
and I think the reason I've chosen that is because the games have really put a smile on all our faces, not just the sport, but also the entertainment. And you can see, after a difficult 2 years, what it means to the fans in the crowd as well.
Absolutely. And, of course, the volunteers. We would not be anywhere without those volunteers.
Very well said.
You know, they've put their heart and soul into this, so they deserve a bit of a round of applause and a pack on the back. Like, it's amazing.
It's so well said. They have been. I mean, where we're sitting right here, we can see a lot of those volunteers and the work they're doing. It's funny, when I've had it myself a few times, I've been wandering around, and it's like they know you look lost. There's always somebody there.
Absolutely.
Yes, I am lost. Yes. Where should I be right now?
And we should take this opportunity to say thank you to the magnificent people of Birmingham, because you have been incredible, and the welcome we've had here to this amazing city has been nothing short of sensational. But what I thought about that was that it was such a good idea, because they were dancers. So the dancers were basically entertaining people in between the rounds. You went to the beach volleyball as well, didn't you?
And that was interesting, because so many people, whenever obviously that went viral on social media, were going, oh my goodness, you know, this raker has just had his moment, you know, he's been waiting.
Which is what I thought as well.
I think that's the aim of the game, I suppose.
Yeah, exactly. But they had the foresight to go, actually, what we'll do is we'll put you in a games maker outfit and you can entertain the crowd. Well, I thought it was really clever.
And exactly what you say is, you know, the crowds, particularly over at Smithfield, where the volleyball, the atmosphere there has been electric. And the fact that the fans are back together again, enjoying, you know, a spectacle like that. It's not just about the sport here. You know, it's called the Friendly Games. And let me tell you, it has been the friendliest place on earth right now.
Yeah. And my second choice, because that's the entertainment side of me. You know, I love singing and dancing, of course.
Is there some sport in here?
Yes, there's a little bit of sport here. But also, the reason I've chosen this moment is because I certainly hope that women's T20 cricket stays in the Commonwealth Games forever, because it's been absolutely wonderful. Congratulations to Australia, who beat India yesterday. Fantastic crowd at Edgbaston. I went along yesterday evening, and the women's 2020 has been... You can see what it means to the Australian women's cricket team. They know how to win. Fantastic performance from Australia. Some of the games have been terrific. Disappointed that England got knocked out in the semi-finals, of course, but yet again showing just what a wonderful sport cricket is. T20 as well. Fans loved it at Edgbaston, and it helped. It was in a world-class test venue as well. But again, the volunteers did an amazing job. I went along to 3 matches. I was there yesterday evening. So I certainly hope that 2020 stays in the Commonwealth Games.
And what a venue.
Oh, I mean, what, you're talking about one of the best venues in England in Test cricket as well, so fantastic.
No, it has been. It's been incredible. And, you know, you mentioned Australia there too. Have been absolutely dominant. We were chatting to a few Australians who said when they first arrived in Birmingham that everyone was so welcoming and so happy to see them. And then they started winning every medal in sight. And might have been in their heads a little bit. And they said, no one wants to talk to us anymore. We'll still talk to you. We're a lot of love for Australia here. We're absolutely loving it.
I feel like you're wearing
a bit of Australian vibes today. I think it's been rubbing off on me a little bit. I'm going to sign up on a medal of my own. Tanya, I have to ask you, what has been the best moment for you?
Oh, there's been so many, but I think for me, the men's 3 metre, seeing 1, 2 and 3, England, shall I say, England on that podium. That was fantastic. And not to forget James, who were 4th from Scotland. So, yeah, GB as a team were right up there, which was fantastic to watch.
I think that's been kind of the theme of the diving, you know, just how high the standard is at the minute, not just for England, of course, but, you know, we're seeing Scotland today and for Wales too. I mean, it's just been phenomenal watching the standard in the dive, and the crowds have absolutely loved it. And it's something we've said over and over again. Some of the names we might not have heard before, but they'll be household names.
We will know them now, that's for sure. And they deserve that, because they've put their all into that and got fantastic results. Look at them with the flag. How amazing. What a picture. I've seen that all over my Instagram.
Oh.
Yeah, it was great, really good.
Have you had a chance to speak to many of the competitors? Is it starting to kind of, you know, as they relax now and celebrate and enjoy themselves?
I've messaged a few of them. I did go up and watch a few prelims, but obviously with the finals, I've been here. So, yeah, they've all been really, really amazed by how fantastic the whole venues are and how the games have gone. And now they can relax a little bit, go home. But some of them do go off to Europeans next week. So 2 days rest and that's it.
That's the thing we forget constantly, don't we? We start to wind down here, reflect on what an incredible Games it's been for. But for so many of the athletes, they get kind of 2 days off, one pizza, straight back
That's
on it again.
Exactly it. Quickly get as much as you go see everyone, go see your friends. Yeah, so it's all back in straight after this Games.
So it would just be who chose the singing and dancing? Just me, yeah?
Just. We know you love a little boogie. Will you promise us to give us a wee dance before the end of the show? Akawan. I'll get you a rake and everything.
Right then, what is the Commonwealth? Well, it means and represents different things to different people, of course, as Birmingham's poet laureate Casey Bailey beautifully explains.
From one side of the world to the other, and back in the other direction. A group not like sister and brother. There's a different form of connection. How it's seen now could be a lot of things, mainly based on your perception. But for clarity, its origin was certainly a collection. From Bangladesh to Barbados, there runs a single link, this commonality in a commonwealth that may be larger than you think. 2.5 billion people, if you combine the populations of those held under this banner, 56 separate nations. Of those this banner held under, English mixed with mother tongues that emphasize the ties to different times aren't yet undone. Learning words like democracy, equality, and freedom.
There is a new African in the world.
But ironically, in their teaching, didn't always get to see them. Some will look back with nostalgia based on stories now recited. Some look forward to the Games, say we should surely be excited. Some see pushback against the empire as love that's unrequited. Some would argue it was great. None could claim it was invited. Now the pride of many nations is in national museums and national trust. How could you or I tell 56 nations this is just? People died for this to start. People lived because it did. We can't slide that in a jar and simply slip back on the lid. Check the galleries and palaces for the evidence of wrongdoing, saying let go of the past whilst literally holding onto it. So we won't always feel glory, but we do have champions with more inspiring stories. Grandparents shaped by war, and those who traveled from distant lands, came to build a home and rebuilt a nation with their hands. We've seen the artists of this world turn our canvas into a masterpiece. We've seen Stormzy in a Banksy vest out on the pyramid stage at Glastonbury. We've seen athletes fall down and somehow rise back to their feet. For the flag they will compete, not accepting a defeat. For all those who choose to rock their vest, rep their people, face the crowd, these Commonwealth Games are your stage to do your country proud.
Thank you to Casey for producing that beautiful film, which I think highlights the diversity of Birmingham. It's something that we've noticed. I've managed to travel around, ate in a restaurant in Small Heath just a few nights ago, and incredibly diverse, so multicultural, and that's what's made these Games very special for me, Holly.
Isn't it? And you're so right. It's something that's... It's so embraced here. Everyone's individuality, as you say, multiculturalism. It's a really beautiful thing, it's an incredible city for that. You know, you see so many cultures here, and it's one of the reasons, you know, when this city was chosen, it was highlighted. You know,
and
you've really felt it here. It's been fantastic, and you know, it's what the Commonwealth Games is all about.
Yeah, it's been amazing, hasn't it? When you've been meeting people from Birmingham, the people here are so proud that the Games are here.
Do you know what? I've got a few Ubers, and every single person in that Uber have said how amazing it's been for Birmingham, and they have watched every single sport. They've been following it on their radio. Yeah, it's fantastic, and I'm so pleased it's gone so fantastically well.
It's funny, you speak to so many of the crowds out here that they're local, you know, they haven't maybe travelled too far to come here. And like you say, they feel so proud to be from here. And the first thing they ask me, you know, is, what do you think? What do you think of Birmingham? Yeah. What do you think of our city? And I've got to say, I speak for a lot of people when we say we've just been blown away by how welcoming they have been, how incredible the city is, how beautiful it is, the architecture, the buildings. And, you know, so many people weren't aware of that before, before they came here.
It's been a real boost for the city, hasn't it?
Yeah.
And hopefully now the city can kick on now, because there's a great slogan there. Denise Lewis was in here talking about this very thing. There's a great slogan that says, sport is just the beginning.
Yeah.
And now it's about the city taking on and building on the legacy.
And it's been amazing that a few buildings have been built because of this sports, and now they have it, especially the diving pool and the swimming pool. That wasn't there before this Games. So it's great they've got another great facility in their place. So.
And that's what it's all about, the legacy and what's to come when these Games, when we up and leave and what's left behind.
I know. Yeah.
And you're staying with us, aren't you? Because we are now concentrating on the mixed synchro final, which we'll show you some pictures live of in a moment, the 10 metre. What are you expecting here, Tonya?
Well, Kyle and Lewis don't train together normally, so this is very, very new.
Oh, we loved that. Thanks to Kat and to Leon there. But, oh, brilliant. What a result. England top 1-2 there. Fantastic.
Oh, well, you could see them jumping in, how amazing and how excited they are. Like, just for us watching, it feels so amazing. Imagine being in that crowd. Like, that was insane diving. And men and women together, you don't know how it's going to go. And, well, it just proved us wrong there, didn't
it? You know, something we talked about earlier is it's very, very difficult to predict how this is going to go. But we mentioned Andrea and Noah, the first time we've seen them competing internationally, and it was just perfect.
Absolutely. 3-3-3 is what they scored, and that's huge. That's absolutely massive, especially in synchro, you know? Like, and the fact that it was men and women, I bet they can't believe it. I bet they're in full-on shock.
Before we analyse some of the dives, let's talk about Australia, because we talked about them as well. Disappointing for them, Sonia.
This is what diving is all about. We've got our two divers from Australia, which is, like, world-class, and they came sixth. So you just don't know what's going to happen on the day. So I think they're going to be pretty disappointed with that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's take a look at some of the dives then, and let's start with the fourth round, because, as Holly says, I mean, we're talking about really impressive competition here, but look at this. They absolutely nailed this, Tonya.
That's it. Oh, my goodness. They could completely disappear. Yeah, you see Noah a tiny bit, but that's expected when you do a mixed synchro. Mm-hmm. But they land in the water at the same time. Their somersaults might be a little bit off, but in fast motion, you don't really see that. It's only because we're seeing it in slow-mo. You always see what's wrong in slow motion. And luckily, the judges don't see a slow-mo afterwards.
OK, delighted to say that Noah and Andrea are with Kat live. Let's head to Kat.
Yes, two gold medals each for Noah Williams and Andrea Spendolini-Sirix. Andrea, what were your expectations coming into that? Because there were pairs in there with multiple World Olympic medals, multiple Commonwealth medals. And at 17 years old, you know, this has been your Games.
Yeah, it's been incredible. I think we came in wanting to have fun, and we definitely did. It's a PB for our synchro, actually. But I'm just really pleased with how we executed our dives and our synchro, and it's been really, really fun.
It does look fun. Is mixed diving more fun than the other events now?
I think because it's not in the Olympics, some people take it less seriously. And not that, obviously, it's at the Commonwealth Games, so it's not that nobody was taking it seriously here, but we are just able to have a bit more fun and enjoy ourselves more, yeah.
And another gold medal for Team England. We saw you celebrating diving into the pool at the end. It's been a brilliant Games. Was that celebration planned?
Yeah, it was, actually. I told Noah, I said, if we do well, we should all just belly flop into the pool. It was definitely an amazing celebration. And I'm just really proud of everyone.
We've got to allow you one belly flop over the course of a week. What do you start thinking about now, Andrea, as a two-time Commonwealth champion, a silver medal as well, three Commonwealth medals to take home from this game?
Well, now we've got Europeans, so I'm going to focus on that. But after that, I'm just going to take a break, have my summer holiday, and then come back even stronger.
And Noah, celebration for you, a holiday perhaps?
Yeah, I'm going on holiday with my girlfriend, but that's after Europeans, so a couple weeks wait, and then I get to go to Greece with my girlfriend, so that'll be lovely.
Who knows, maybe some more medals in the pool in Rome in a week's time, and you'll have a whole new host of fans following you as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's been really incredible to have all these fans here. Like, normally we have nationals, and literally the parents of the divers turn up, so it's been a crazy experience to have everyone here, but I've really enjoyed it.
We can see Grace Reed and James Heatley about to get their gold medal for the mixed 3 metre behind you, so we'll let you go and get ready for your medal ceremony.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Brilliant work. Well done, guys.
So young, yet so assured, aren't they, in the interviews?
Exactly what I was saying.
17 years old, speaking like that after an interview. I mean, how impressive.
I definitely wasn't speaking like that at a 17-year-old. I'd be like, no, she's amazing. It's absolutely brilliant. So easily, like, she just comes off the tip of her tongue,
so
doesn't
composed,
it?
Yeah. Yeah, and, you know, just taking it all in her stride. Two gold medals for both of them at these Games. And what an achievement. And we've mentioned it a few times, her age. And it just says a lot about the future of diving, doesn't it? So in very safe hands.
Oh, absolutely. And it's lovely to see the up-and-coming divers absolutely smashing it and taking it, you know. Good for them, good for them.
Do you know, it made me laugh whenever we were listening to those questions there and Kat was asking, is this the most fun competition, you know, with the mixed synchro? And you were nodding along really profusely. Like, what makes it so fun?
Like they said, it's not in the Olympics at the moment, so it's just something different. You don't have to take it full on seriously. So I think these guys, as you can see, they just smiled throughout the whole competition. Yeah. Both events, you know, like Lois and Kyle did exactly the same, and they could just enjoy, bounce off each other. And that's why all four of them dived amazingly, because the pressure was off.
Yeah. Beautifully setting up Kyle and Lois, because they are with Kat Downs.
Yep, it's going to be an England 1-2 because Lois Toulson and Kyle Kattari have delivered the silver medal. Just applauding there for your team, GB teammates there, Kyle, for James Heatley and Grace Reed, who are getting their gold medals behind you. But you are a scratch team, just started training together this week, delivered a silver medal for Team England.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, we were a bit like, is this going to work? There's always that you get thrown together and then, you know, I think we had a little inkling that it was going to work, and yeah, obviously today it shows that, you know, I mean, I'm literally speechless. I was literally fourth the other day. I was like, oh, this has to be a redemption day. So,
and it is a redemption day. What's that magic ingredient then, Lois, that has made this pairing work today?
I'm not sure, to be honest. I mean, we've known each other for a long time, and I think Kyle said today that I think it's 8 years ago since we both became junior European champions. So we've done a lot of competitions together and we've known each other for a long time. So I think when we were put together, we knew that, you know, it could work. And yeah, we've only done them dives like 2 or 3 times each. So to put a list like that together, we're really pleased.
Kyle mentioned his fourth place finish a few days ago. This is 2 silvers for you, and it's been such a grind, such a journey for you over the past season or so to get back to your best. That must really mean a lot.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I was looking forward to this competition. It's been one of my only, like, major internationals of the season. And I knew that I could do well, but obviously it's diving and anything can happen. But to come away with 2 silvers, I'm really happy.
We've heard from the others' plans for pizza eating, holidays with their boyfriends and girlfriends. What's next for you, Lois?
Just similar, to be honest. I mean, we've both got Europeans.
A nice one day rest.
Yeah, we literally have one day rest and then we go to Europeans. But then I think after that, we're obviously going to take some time off and enjoy what's left of summer.
Sometimes all the divers go on holiday together. Is that part of the plans, Kyle?
I wish. I hope we get a few days off in Rome to actually explore. But no, definitely after we get back. I've been trying to organise. I keep getting blanked in the group chat, unfortunately.
Oh, we'll be having words. Come on, you've got to invite Carla.
Strong words.
Well, look, enjoy the celebrations here. You're one day off, and we'll see you in Rome.
Thank you. Cheers.
I'd quite like to see that WhatsApp group, to be honest with you. There would be plenty in that to look at.
Now's not the time to ask about diving holidays.
Yeah, exactly. One
on daytime
day
television.
You may have heard the medal ceremony was going on in the middle of that there with Flower of Scotland. You were going to hear that in all its glory in just a few minutes, so I'm going to enjoy
indeed.
That. But do you know what's really interesting about Lois and Kyle? And we talked about it earlier. They were thrown together at the last minute. They've only done those dives a couple of times. Makes this even more remarkable.
Absolutely. It can take years to be able to put a synchro pairing together to do well and score over 300, and it took 2 dives. They must stay together, because if that's what they're doing now, God knows what's going to happen in the future. So they must stay together as a team. That
but also,
fantastic.
How nerve-wracking that must be.
Oh, it could either go both ways. Very nerve-wracking, or it could be like, do you know what? We've got no pressure on us. Let's just go in there and enjoy. So,
Yeah.
I'm buzzing for them.
I'll
Good
bet
for them.
You are. I mean, it must be really amazing for you to watch Lois, because that was your synchro partner at the Olympics. I mean, and she was, what, 16 years 16. Old when you were partnered?
Absolutely. So myself and Lois was thrown together 8 months before the Olympic Games, which is ridiculous. We were up against the Canadians that were together for 10 years. Oh, no, we weren't. That was the year before, sorry. Probably 4 or 5 years, sorry, was the next guys. And that was us for 8 years. And the fact that she's this young girl thrown into this huge Olympic game, she held it together. Yeah, and we've seen potential in her for sure.
Yeah, and I mean, just how well they work together too, like you say. We hope we can see this again.
Oh, they best. I'm going to call her right now.
In fact, we've got some analysis of their fifth dive as well. I mean, you know, it's been a terrific competition. It's been such a thrilling morning, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. And do you know what? They're very similar divers. When they get their hands, basically in diving terms, when they land on the water, they completely disappear. And they're just very similar, and I think it works really, really well, hence why they did so well. But Lois jumps very, very high for a female diver, so it helped for Kyle to keep his normal cool and jump like he normally jumps.
Well, congratulations to them as well. It's an incredible achievement. And you must be, well, you are, you're buzzing. You've used that word. You must be buzzing for the Olympics.
I am.
In 2 years' time.
Because I am.
Look at GB's divers. You know, we've seen Scotland, we've seen Wales as well.
Yeah.
You know, amazing. And also, when you look at the medal table with England in the diving, I mean, this puts them in such a great position looking ahead to Paris.
Absolutely. And the other countries, best watch out. They're doing amazing, aren't they?
Yeah, look at this. 15 medals in total for England. 6 of those gold. It does tell you everything. And look at Scotland in there as well. I mean, it's just great to see that. A gold medal for them, of course.
But also topping any medal table, especially in diving, in which Australia are competing as well. I mean, how fantastic an achievement is that?
I know, yes, absolutely. In Australia, you know, they're pretty up there, aren't they? So it's great that we're following just behind.
Yeah, we mentioned that gold medal for Scotland. The Grace Reid and James Heatley won the mixed synchronised throw that you don't get to see on the television. And, you know, we get to see this part, you know, when they stand there. But during the medal ceremony, everybody has their moment. Every individual's name is mentioned. And the crowd, no matter who they are. So I was down at the hockey yesterday. And again, you know the rivalry between Australia and England in the hockey too. And the crowd for Australia, they went wild. Yeah. I mean, the silver medalists, and you know, it's great to see, and that's what it's about, that moment to enjoy it, to savour it.
Yeah, absolutely. But what an impressive morning in the diving today. It's been so good, isn't it?
I know. What did you get up to Monday morning? Oh, I won a couple of medals here and there.
Yeah, exactly. Let's have a look then at the medal ceremony for the 10-metre mixed synchro. Silver and gold to England, of course. 56 gold medals, brilliant.
Oh, it's great to see them all huddled up there as well. That's what it's about, the friendly games, isn't it?
It's like us at the end of the show.
As we're, I'm normally lying down, to be honest. I don't know about you. Lying in a heap in the corner.
I know, I feel tired. Can you imagine these guys?
It's been a great morning. Tonya, thank you so much for your time.
Oh, really good to see you. Thank you for having me. I've absolutely loved it.
Thank you. You've been brilliant.
It's been brilliant. Enjoy the rest of the day. Enjoy the closing ceremony tonight.
Thank you. And yourselves.
Thank you. Right, we're heading over to the NEC now. Welsh pair Charlotte Carey and Anna Hersey are in the women's doubles bronze medal match.
Yeah, victory here would give Wales their second table tennis medal of these games, following Joshua Stacey's gold yesterday. And we join the action at the start of the fourth game. Commentary coming from Donald Parker and Simon.